But the major part is on assets like this, which I'm explaining now. So they issued, right? They issued a CDS to ICICI Bank. Now what happens? Please understand this. If ICICI Bank is purchasing that CDS, what is ICICI Bank now indicating? It is now telling Standard Chartered, if Tata's default, I'm there, I'll pay you. What's your problem? I'm there, no? I'm purchasing a CDS, here it is. If they default, you wanted a CDS, no? I'm there, I'm coming in. Now, point you will ask me is, right, why did ICICI do it? Please understand, there are no free lunches. Why did ICICI do it? Because, right, for a guarantee, you all have read about guarantee for the beginners, right? Whenever we stand guarantee, dosti khata mein hote ho alag hai, but a banks vagara, when they give guarantee, they charge a guarantee fees. Now in a CDS, the fees is higher. What ICICI Bank did is, they said, yeah, yeah, we'll issue a CDS, we will buy it, and we'll tell them that if you default, I'll come in, provided you pay me a fees. This is what we call as fee-based income. They earned a fees. Now the difference between a CDS and a guarantee is, a CDS is traded. It's traded, sir, on Singapore Stock Exchange. It's traded, right, in Luxembourg Stock Exchange. It starts getting traded. It is a traded instrument. Dekhi abhi. Now please understand, right, one more term. Right, I'll give you a proper noting of this, but I just want to finish this case study on ICICI. It is what we call as, again, you have been reading this, credit derivative. It's a credit derivative. What's a credit? What is a derivative? That's it. Somebody said that. Thanks. Derivative comes from, right, the underlying. The term was said, underlying. Credit derivative is, this instrument will be floated depending, it will move depending on the risk of default, credit default swap. Now watch what happened, ICICI. Now you will go back, right? Unfortunately, none of you all heard Ms. Kocher speak. She explicitly said that. She said, yeah, we have taken losses, the colleague said, right? We have taken hit on the subprime, but the major part is mark to market. We have taken a loss, but the major part is mark to market, right? We went back and we analyzed this, and that's exactly what was revealed. What happened is, they had purchased CDS, okay? They had the CDS of Tata's, various others. Now, please understand why they did this. I again want to repeatedly tell all of you all that it is fee-based income. And for those of you all who are specializing in finance, just 1 minute for them, right? The income in CDS is much higher than a guarantee fees, because I know I have the pleasure of some bankers here. Guarantee fees, you will get 4 to 6 times that in CDS, because guarantee typically is secured, CDS is unsecured. See, how the bank issues a guarantee typically is, they'll take a deposit from you and say, on that deposit, I'll give you a guarantee. Typically, so it's secured. Nahi dega chalega, deposit hai. CDS is unsecured. ICICI went for this, got their fee-based income. Now comes the last part of my discussion. The credit default, right? Moment the credit squeeze happened, across the line, please understand the subprime, we have discussed this, the subprime erupted. Across the line, please understand, the default premiums went up. Default premiums went up. Sir, I need to tell you one thing which is important. If you have one stock which is part of a system and the system collapses, you can't expect your stock to hold its ground. It will fall. It's simple, as simple as that, right? The markets are not doing well, everything would come down. That's exactly what happened. When the default started, default premiums went up. Across the line, default premiums went up. Correspondingly, even here, the premiums went up. Even here, the premiums went up. Go ahead, please.
Yes.
No, no, no. It's a one-time payment. which is booked as fee-based income. Absolutely. Which has taken the loan, yeah.